फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू ओडिया ब्लॉग्स। आज इस ब्लॉग में मैंने राजा रानी टेम्पल ये कवर किया है और ये गार्डन मेरा पीछे है, मैं दिखा रही हूँ आपको, एक बार देख लीजिए। इवनिंग का टाइम है, हवा चल रही है और बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है मुझे। अभी पार्क जैसा सुंदरता है यहाँ और बिल्कुल मेरे पीछे है राजा रानी टेम्पल। ये है, देख लीजिए। और टेम्पल में कोई गॉड या गॉडेस वैसे कुछ नहीं है, खाली है, लेकिन पुराना टाइम का है, ओल्ड टाइम का है टेम्पल, तो काफ़ी काम किया हुआ है टेम्पल का आउटसाइड में, वो मैंने ले लिया है और आप उसको देख सकते हैं। तो यही व्लॉग है आज, तो देखते रहिए कैसे लग रहा है, कमेंट कीजिए ज़रूर। द राजा रानी टेम्पल, इट इज़ लोकेटेड इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ खोर्दा टू द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न साइड ऑफ द लिंगराज टेम्पल एंड कैन बी ईजीली एक्सेस्ड यूजिंग एनी मीन्स ऑफ पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट, ऑटोज एंड कैब्स, एंड इट इज़ ओपन फ्रॉम 6:30 AM टू 7:30 PM एंड देयर इज़ अ स्मॉल एंट्री फी ऑफ ₹15। It is a popular 11th century Hindu temple that can be found in Bhubaneswar, the capital of Odisha in India. The Raja Rani temple is locally known as the Love Temple because it contains some sensuous carvings of women and couples. No images can be found inside the sanctum, and hence the temple is not associated with any particular sect of Hinduism. This is perhaps exactly where the charm of the temple comes from. The temple belongs to no specific sect and is open to all people irrespective of the deity that they worship and admire. However, the figures of Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati carved on the walls strongly indicate that the temple has certain associations with Shaivism. According to historians, it was constructed at some time between the 11th and 12th century, but the exact period has not yet been ascertained. In fact, it is from the Raja Rani temple that the architecture of other temples in central India is believed to have been developed. The most notable examples being the Khajuraho temples and the Toteshwara Mahadeo temple in Kadava. The Raja Rani temple is currently under the care of the Archaeological Survey of India and is maintained as a ticketed monument, that is, tourists need to purchase a ticket to enter the temple. The Raja Rani temple has an altogether different charm to offer, and this is perhaps what sets it aside and apart from the other temples that one can find scattered all across Bhubaneswar, which is now rightly known as the temple metropolis of Odisha. The spectacular temple had to be refurbished and renovated in the year 1903 after it reached a dilapidated state. It continues to hold a prestigious place among the holy places in Bhubaneswar even after these years. The structure of Raja Rani temple has a lot of symbolism and deep meaning attached to it that never fails to intrigue historians. The striking temple was constructed using a reddish gold kind of sandstone, which is known as Raja Rani in the local dialect, and hence this name for the temple. The glorious temple has been constructed in the Panchatattva style. This means that the temple is built on a raised platform and comprises of two structures. The central shrine is known as the Vimana or Sanctum, which is at the height of 17.9 meters and has a curvilinear spire over the roof that rises to a height of 59 feet. The viewing hall is known as Jagamohana and has a pyramidal roof. The Vimana is the main sanctum, while the Jagamohana is the place from where the devotees can view the sanctum. Three panels can be found on the facade of the main temple, which shows images of Lord Shiva dancing and enjoying with his partner, Goddess Parvati, in the company of some attendants who are playing musical instruments in the background. A carving depicting the holy matrimony between Shiva and Parvati can also be found on the western side, just below the central niche of the temple. A Naga and Nagini are present at the entrance of the temple, which led to the widespread common belief among the locals that the king or the Raja and the queen or the Rani are associated with the temple, and that is why the structure is called Raja Rani Temple. This belief, however, is not accepted by historians. Other than the marriage scenes of Shiva, Nataraja and Parvati, the sculptures in the walls around the temple also depict certain additional scenes and also include sophisticated, tall and slim Naikas in different modes and roles. While some are seen holding a branch of a tree, some are fondling with their children or turning their heads away from an emaciated ascetic, while others are attending to their toilet, looking into a mirror, taking